Hello, everybody. Welcome back to OCD HiFi Guy, where you get to learn some new cool stuff or some old stuff. Okay, so what we're featuring today is I am showing you guys some single-ended triode. Again, although these are more traditional single-ended triode tubes, the 845. Those are the tube that you see back there. Those are the power output tubes. These are also transmitter tubes, okay? Roughly, well, if you squeeze them, 35, maybe 30 each. This amp is rated at 50 watts of pure Class A single-ended triode, okay? And what I'm going to do first is, well, first let me show you about these amps. Okay, so the first thing we have to do is we've got two sides, and these tubes, we bias them, which means we adjust the voltage that goes through here, the bias voltage. That's like the thing that you put on the grid that, well, I'm not even going to start to try and explain. But the bottom line is it adjusts the amount of electrons that flow through from one side to the other. So we go here, we've got a, just, you need a meter and with two probes. You go into here, you see your spots, test point right there. Shows you, so you put the red one in the red, black one in the black. And over here, we've got 15.76, okay? We want 16, which is the ideal. Screwdriver, go. Okay, so, we're going to grab screwdriver with something with a plastic handle. You know, you can, it can be metal on the bottom, but you want plastic where you're holding it. And then we go over here to the bias adjust. See that screw? And we're going to bring this one up to 16 and keep her there. Okay, back a little. Okay. Okay, right there. Okay, 16. Okay, now we're going to go to the other side over here, and we will also put the probes in. Put one here, and pull that around, okay? Put one here, okay? We got 15.57. Bring this one up. Okay, what that does is that balances the two sides, keeps them so they're both at the same, in the same place, which is good. Now we also have a 300B tube up here and a 6SN7. Well, it's actually a CV181, which is a derivative, but it's also, you can use it in 6SN7. It's very heavy duty. It's a great piece. I had these in old RCAs, and I'll tell you what, man, I just don't think I like NOS, the old 6SN7s. They're so noisy, and oh my god, you don't ever bump one. Be real careful. If you got one in an amp and you bump that thing, man, whew, you're gonna get a real surprise. Okay, the big tubes, not so much. Okay, so we've got 1593. We're cool there. So we're gonna go here, bias adjust. Oops, wrong one. Here, and we're going to go put it up to 16. Okay, and I'm going to pause right now because I don't want this video to be so long. I'll pause, I'll do the other one, and I'll be right back. Okay, I am back, and those are all biased up. We're good on the bias, and now I'm going to go through some of the songs that we've been playing just so we can have a point of reference. And I put in the clips here. What we're using now are Forte 2. And with a slight mod on them, I have done, inside I did some things on the crossover, just put some higher caliber components on there, tried to damp some of this, the cabinet, because these things really resonate. They're just almost big hollow boxes, you know? I don't know if they designed the cabinet resonance into the way they sound, they're supposed to sound, but I'd rather take it out. So, I took out as much as I could, and we put spikes on the bottom, and so it's pretty basic, not a real heavy mod, and the internal wiring. So we'll go ahead, and this is going to be your taste of 845s with 300B and 6SN7 drivers, and I'm going to go through again and play some of the songs. Thank you. Trying to wait till she sings. Super smooth highs there. Here comes some big bass.
Thank you. La 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 la
I dare do this? I don't know. Okay, I do. I'll just do it for a little while. I'm not going to go over there and turn it up. I could, but I'm not going to do it. So listen to a little singing there with him. I think the metal sounded better on the other ones, definitely. Everything else was pretty dang good, man. So, you know, what can we take away? Well, let's see. Let me try something. I want just for shits and giggles. I want to see. Oh, yeah, shit. I forgot. That one gets you red flagged for sure. I can't play that one. It's the Eagles, and it gets you nailed. How about this? This is an audiophile recording. 1644. Treated with Mark Levinson's software.
Isn't he lovely? Isn't he wonderful? Isn't he precious? Less than 1 minute. I never thought through love we.
Okay, I'll get to that. That's another video. But anyways, I'm gonna try and keep this one short. I think I decided that. What I'll do now is I'll just put this one out so you can compare it to the other vids that I've put up recently, and you can compare. We've been comparing amplifiers with the same speakers. This time we went to some more efficient speakers, and I'll tell you why I did the things that I did. Well, here's the first thing. What do you think we've gathered from the things that I've showed you? I think you can probably trust I know good sound. You think? And also, what I'm showing you is I can make a rig. This, okay, right here, this amp in these speakers, these are old. These are like 30 years old or something. You know, I got them. You can get them at garage sales and stuff like that. I got them at some guy's house hoard. But so together, you know, I got these used. So the same price as those speakers, I got these here. And I'd actually sell it too for the same that I have. $5,500 for those amps and for the speakers together, all everything together. So what I'm showing you is that I can also put together a freaking kick-ass rig from cheap all the way up. Okay? No matter what, it doesn't matter if it's cheap or if it's really highfalutin with these big 7-foot panels and the other stuff that we'll go back to. But I just want to show you that it's across the map. You don't have to be rich to enjoy real hi-fi, which a lot of people mistakenly think. If you know where to look, or if you just trust somebody to tell you, that will tell you where to look, or tell you, or sell you something, you know, that is a person that is a reseller that you trust, you don't have to spend a lot of money. I mean, everything that I heard in those first songs was very close. I mean, between all these amps, they're not a huge distance away. And even though we went, okay, these speakers are like $800 speakers, right? I mean, we really dropped down in price from, you know, $5,500 to $800. But I mean, to me, everything, except for the metal, right? The metal was kind of like, it was not as good as the other ones, but everything before that was just as good. I mean, I felt it was in the same ballpark. Let's say that if I had this going and I was listening to those tunes, I wouldn't necessarily miss the other ones. Okay. When you put the other ones in, they do different things and you'll be able to listen back and forth. What you do is you open a couple windows with YouTube and you have a couple windows and make them smaller in your monitor. And then you can open each one to each different vid. That's the way you can toggle between videos, on YouTube. So this was an exercise just to show you how single-ended triode monoblocks, you can get those. I mean, they didn't cost an arm and a leg, you know. I mean, those things used roughly, you know, 5K, something like that. You know, the speakers, you know, 800 is what I got. I paid for those. So you can pick them up, 800, 500, depends where you are and you know, probably get them cheap now. But you can't go outside. Can't go outside to go get them, can you? So we're listening, and again, we're listening to DAC preamp, server. Okay, server, DAC preamp, and then to these two amps, and then just to these clips. We have no subwoofers or anything else going on. There's a little example of an 845. Okay, so don't want to keep you too much longer. That's it. Thanks for coming back, and see you.